Obi-Wan always at that last minute jump. Let me see if I can jump up there. Oh, nice. I think we got all of them then. Guess we did. Sweet. Noise. Absolutely noise. Now, I think they made a bonus level for this, this episode as well. But I don't think it's actually in the actual campaign. It's actually in the actual campaign. I don't think it's in the actual campaign. It's one of the bonus levels. Like, there's a room of bonus levels. We'll do a few of those. Yeah, I think one of them, you watched the trailer for Lego Indiana Jones, which is the next Lego project, which was pretty exciting. Because I was like, whoa, a Lego game that's not Lego Star Wars. This is kind of cool. And, if you watch it, you get literally Indiana Jones as an unlockable character. That's kind of cool. Let me shoot him with my chrome pistol. I'll try pushing buttons. That works. Whoa. Now this is pod racing. Had to throw that quote in somewhere. Whoa, this is pod racing. Whoa. Because I'll literally not have another opportunity to say that. I will not have another super slap for all your bitchy needs. Wow, that's all the characters? I look at the roster for Lego Avengers, and it's like two times the size of this. It's big. And I thought that was a lot of characters at the time. But no, this is bigger. This is bigger. And that includes duplicates of the same characters, too. So, like, that's something the newer Lego games also account for, is that if there's duplicates of the same character, you'll find it in the same slot. And they're also alphabetized, too. They're also in alphabetical order. It's kind of interesting. True Jedi. I think we only have one level left in this episode. We all know what it is, I think. Or what we're going up against, rather. The episode you're already watching, The Phantom Menace, continues. Damn. Chapter 6. Oh, I'm excited for this part. We'll take this alone. Darth Maul. It's pretty badass at the hood. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Duel the Fates. Literally, probably the best piece of music from the entire prequel trilogy. To be very, very honest. Absolutely the best piece of music from John Williams. It's iconic. It's memorable. It's addicting to listen to. It's suspenseful, you know? It's everything you need to be. Da, 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 da. And it's like in Phantom Menace, which is surprising, you know. Took a dark take. And it feels dark and evil too, you know. All right, here we go. This is not hard. You just gotta learn to deflect. You just gotta have a personality. There we go. This is the first ever LEGO boss fight, to be fair. Like, back when LEGO Star Wars 1, this was the very first boss fight they ever did, you know? More of them come out. It's really a rinse and repeat process, but it's very short, so... That was really quick. Ooh, what the? There we go. Cool. Now, please drop your bridges. I mean, your bridge, whatever. Just drop it, you know? Two hearts. All right, another level I have to get True Jedi in because curse my OCD, well-being, my OCD-ness, my OCD-ness. It sounds like a droid. OCDS, anybody? No, okay. Works for me, you know. All right, let's get this thing back on. Oh, there's a mini kill. Oh, this thing's gonna take off after we do that, I think. Yeah, it will. Damn it, don't take off. Don't you take off. So many coins. So many coins. I hate how they go everywhere though. That's the annoying part, because I can't get all of them, you know? And your character doesn't move fast enough for them to get all of them either, so. I need a stud magnet. That's what I need. A stud magnet. So I can attract studs. No, I need to be the opposite. I need to be a stud magnet so I can... I don't attract studs. You know? Because I am a stud. I don't need to attract studs. I'd rather know someone who could attract studs. Ideally, of the female variety. Okay, this is getting really awkward. When you make it awkward. Sorry. Just didn't mean to. Okay. I know this one probably takes off after I lift it. I'm pretty sure that's what it does. Let me get your coins. Allow me to have your coins. Somehow one of these takes off, though. I think it's the other one. I don't know what you have to do to get it to take off. I forget. I do not remember. Get all them coins. Get all them coins. Let's go up here, Obi-Wan. Obi-Wan, come on. Make up your mind, man. There we go. And, of course, the studs on that side, which we won't be able to get to. But there's purple, what am I saying? Blue studs up here, so that makes it worth it. Stormtrooper panel. Of course. There we go. Stormtrooper. Oh, that's what we need to do. Okay. Wait! There we go. Takes off. No idea who's in it either. No, he's just waiting there, watching the whole thing go down. Like a stealth sequence. You know, he's stealthing Lego Star Wars right now. He's just doing stealth version. Look at those pretty trees. Look at that background. That Bob Ross background. Oh, can I drive this around? Yes! Whoa. Oh, shit. Not intentional at all. And now it's gonna continually crash until the end of time. Basically. Here, I got this. I can collect all the studs. Yeah, I got all the studs. Alright, Obi-Wan, let's progress. Darth Maul, you can't win, Darth. Seriously, though, what the hell? Killing off Darth Maul in the first movie. He wasn't even the equivalent of a grunt, like a brute grunt that you would see in other movies, like James Bond, or, like Lego Indiana, or, what am I saying, Lego Indiana Jones, just Indiana Jones in general, like, you always have the brute, that he goes up against in each movie. Like, you know, the airplane guy in Raiders of the Lost Ark, the thuggy slave driver in Temple of Doom. And, you know, he didn't have to be that. He definitely didn't have to be that, and he wasn't setting up to be that either, but he was. How disappointing, you know? Yeah, we'll get True Jedi. We will get True Jedi. Take it on down to Disco Town. There's coins up there. I don't think I'll be able to get to them. Oh, wait, I will. I will be up there. There's a lot of studs up there. Or maybe I won't be able to get up there. She Hanagized. Hanagized. As in hand? Han dies? No? I'm rambling at this point. What am I doing? What are you doing with your life? Oh, there's a purple stud over there. Okay, look. It actually exists. The purple stud actually does exist. Much contrary to our previous reports, the purple stud does exist. I know they had it in the OT game, but the original trilogy, but I don't know if they had it in prequels. I don't think they did. So. And I know they never even had it on the DS version, like the mobile version of the game. Why? Why exclude it? You know, why exclude it from there? That is bothersome. Roger. We need a Roger down on apartment Roger. Roger. Over under. Okay. Roger. Just keep Roger on by. Just keep Roger in on by. Minikit. No. Okay. No minikit. Now I'm going to force. Oh my gosh! Let's just let this build up. Let's just let this build up here. Go get yourself pushed off. Oh, there we go, True Jedi. Boom! There we go, that was cool. I was expecting them to all, like, go out in, like, a circumference of destruction, but it didn't actually turn out that way. It was just more like, you know, they just kind of, like, just kind of collapsed, you know? Look at all those coins. Something I learned is that if there's more than, like, 10 silver studs on the ground, like, the game will automatically convert it to a gold stud. Like, all of a sudden, 10 of those silver studs will disappear and a gold stud. Oh my gosh! Too many! Why are there so many droids? Well, Obi-Wan, it looks like we're going to have to fight our way there. We will, though. We will fight our way. So many! Quit calling in droids! Quit calling in droids! Oh my gosh, no! No! My blue studs! I am now less of a stud than I was before. Okay. You know, that's a joke that I've beaten to the ground and then some. Literally, with every Lego game, I'll make that joke. Hey, I'm a stud. Just collecting coins. That's all I do. I'm just collecting coins. Okay, collecting these coins. Riveting stuff. I know one of these has a mini kit. I'm pretty sure one of those beam things has a mini kit. We'll find it. And we'll kill it. We do. I will find you, and I will kill you. See, I can do like the Liam Neeson, like gruffle. That's not a word. I can do like the gruff Liam Neeson. I can do the gruffness of his voice, but I can't like sound at him at a normal point. My name is Liam Neeson. Like you can do the whole Liam Neeson thing at the end, you know. It's not hard to do. Sounding like him beforehand, though, that's like, Liam has a majestic voice, you know, that he has a majestic voice. Wow, that was sad. Stop it! Oh my gosh. I didn't mean to do it, I was just literally jumping up, I was trying to get away, but I lost, like, too many coins. Hey, it's mine! He's like, okay. Okay, master. I'll jump on the other one. Thank you. Why are you doing? Oh, he just tells me to jump off. I like the Darth Maul flip, too, because he'll do his jump and then he'll, like, side flip in the air. Kind of cool. Can't wait to see if the newer LEGO games will change that at all. Force Awakens. Because I imagine they'll have a... I mean, hopefully some of the mini-kit unlocks get you... What is it? Like, you know, hopefully they get you unlockable characters and stuff. Like, that'd be pretty badass, you know? To be honest, I don't know what they get you. I don't know what the newer LEGO games, what the minikits unlock you. Because I know miniature models was a thing in the, It was always a thing in the older LEGO games, but the newer ones, I have no clue. I don't know what they do with them, to be honest, when you get all the minikits. Maybe you get, like, a character or something. I'd probably be more satisfied with that, but I don't know. Oh, there's another LEGO game I forgot. LEGO Pirates of the Caribbean. Because last episode, or whatever episode this was, I was counting on the LEGO games. I forgot LEGO Pirates of the Caribbean. So that's 19 LEGO games. So yeah, very nearly 20 consecutive LEGO games. Very nearly. Alright, now for the boss phase. This is actually kind of difficult. Oh, I hear a minikit. And I will get to it. Let me have my chance. Yeah, this is actually pretty difficult. Like, he doesn't have a lot of openings. Like, you can do this. That'll get rid of his hearts. But other than that, you gotta be careful, because he'll, like, yeah, he'll do that. Okay, hold on. He's gonna kill me! I called it. Please don't. Okay. Like I said, this is pretty hard. Like, he wants you to follow him around. I'm not about that. Stop it! Stop it! Ooh! Can I get him? There we go, I think. Oh no! Oh, the camera actually changed. That's kind of cool. Yo, turn up, Obi-Wan! Oh, for a second there, he's about to jump off. I'm glad I did that hippie flip in the air. Hippie flip? Yeah, just literally do this. That's the strategy that works right now. Alright, here we go. Oh, these mini kits that I won't be able to get. Take that, frying pan. Or take that maul in your frying pan and weird panel thing that just randomly appeared. All these mini kits, my gosh. That's why the newer LEGO games are so long. Because they don't wanna like spoon feed you mini kits like they do in this last part of the level. There's three, heck, maybe four mini kits in this one room. That's really stressful, unless you have invincibility unlocked or anything. Oh! You can't win, Duff. Look at these flips, look at this MLG. Oh, ooh. Ooh, he's got it, he's got it. Believe me, open one. He got it. Oh no! How's he gonna do this? Oh no, his lightsaber's kicked down. How's he gonna do this? How's he gonna get back? Oh, he's got a lightsaber. Rip. Until Clone Wars. Oh, his pants are there still. His pants are just moving around. No! Not Qui-Gon! The only cool character in the Phantom Menace, arguably. And Obi-Wan is pretty cool, but that's only because you know he's Obi-Wan, and other than that, he's just kind of... eh. Eh, you know? Yeah, I don't know why. You know, Phantom Menace really should have just started with Obi-Wan. I mean, Qui-Gon didn't really need to be there. Because he has little relevancy to the movies. But if you watch the Clone Wars, he has a ton of relevance there. Which is kind of funny because he's dead. But he has way more relevance than he does afterward. Or at least the relevance is more obvious than what it is in the movies. You know, the idea of being a Grey Jedi. Which is supposed to mirror the very end of the saga when Luke, you know, becomes the balance. He accepts both light and dark. He's not infinitely light, because that's not balance, you know. And now you think of it, that's something The Force Awakens touches on too, you know. But that's for another day. Because we won! Da-da-da. Thank you for playing this game! This is only the first of six credit sequences that will stick in the game. Pretty fun. Pretty fun. I'm not going to listen through that. 7%. Cool. 7%. Yeah. Meaning if we do all the movies, we'll be at 42%. Sounds legit. All right, guys. That is Phantom Menace. But I don't see any reason to stop there, obviously. We're doing all the movies, quite frankly. You know, if I kept going with the walkthrough, then why wouldn't I not keep going, you know? Before we do that, let's check out what characters we can buy. We have a lot of monies. Ooh, this is literally all the characters. Darth Maul. Get him unlocked. Pit Droid, because why the hell not? Watto, because why the hell not? Padme. No idea why she wasn't already unlocked. Royal Guard. Boss Nass. Most of these are really useless. Captain Tarples, not that useless. He's Jar Jar, but he can fight, which is why he's useful. Droidica, only that expensive because he's cool. Battledroid Commander, no difference from security or Battledroid. Actually, no, there is a difference. I think this one can call in droids or something. He has a little radio. He can do something, I forget. But PK Droid and Gonk Droid. Cool. All the Phantom Menace characters. Not many of them, not many. But that's still nice. Extras. Extras. Beep beep. Meep. Meep meep. Super slap! You know what? I'm gonna turn that on just to have fun with it. I don't know if I have any characters that we can do that with, though. Oh, wait, Captain Panaka. Let me try that. Here, let me just go to extras here. Adaptive difficulty. Oh! Oh, that's why I keep dying to the droidicas. Not very difficult, though. Cool! Wait, let me punch this guy. You know, maybe it's not... Oh, it does work. I think it does work. Wait, Padme is the one who can slap. Here, Padme. Padme! Well, she can't really slap. Padme is the... Leia is the one that has a definitive slap, though. There we go. We still got a lot of monies left over, too, so... You know, I'll check out this bonus room really quick. We're really dragging time here, but it doesn't matter. Nah. Oh, look at that. A level we can build. I wonder what that's for, though. Let's see. I think this is for the bonus Phantom Menace level. Lego City. Oh, no, that's different. How do we already have that unlocked? I don't know. It's weird. Lego City. I'm surprised we already have that unlocked. Gunship Calvary. Ah, I hate that level. Most annoying level in Lego Star Wars 1. Thank God they replaced it, though, in this game. I'm pretty sure this is Anakin's flight. One of these is Anakin's flight. Podrace original. Is there a difference from the actual Podrace in the newer game? I don't know. I don't think there's a difference. Maybe there is, though. Oh, yeah. We gotta skip through this. We can unlock Lego Indiana Jones. Indiana Jones. Skip through it. Yep, we're back in the cantina. I'm not going to watch it because of copyright, but it's still a fun game. See, look. Indiana Jones is now available to buy in the shop. There's Captain Tarples. All right, let's get our Lego Indiana Jones on. He's actually at the very end here. He should be, at least. Oh, it's Bulbous Pod and Indiana Jones. Cool. Cool. We have him unlocked now. Gonk. Gonk. All right, guys. Let's continue the hype with Attack of the Clones. Continuing the hype with some Attack of the Clones. Everyone is fighting, I swear. You know what? I think I may just make a new video for this. So, yeah, just keep things fresh. No matter where this video ends, we'll just start on a new video. So, yeah. Thank y'all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please rate, comment, and subscribe. Check out my other videos upcoming in Power 2, and stay tuned for Attack of the Clones up next in the playthrough. So yeah, thank y'all for watching, and I'll be seeing y'all later.